Standing at your doorway, my stomach all tangled and tight, wrapped in the worst way. Oh God, where are you tonight? 'Cause I don't know what I'm doing here, where to begin. Just take one deep breath, darling, don't let me in. A thousand times we've said, I'm sorry, it's over again. I can't live like this, feel like this in my own skin. It all seems so degrading, and the morning such sin. Your face just like a child, darling, don't let me in. On your bed while we secretly pray like we're mourning the dead. And you tell me you're so weary. I know it's that I'm weary too. You hold back a tear, darling, what are we to do?
Well, so I just decided I couldn't do any of it. I couldn't be in a relationship. They were just too baffling. And I made this conscious decision to quit. Just said, fuck it, I give up. There will be no white wedding, no nice girl, but we're taking it slow, Mom. No white picket fence, no dream of a life together. I can't do it, so I give up. I'll just be something else instead, an artist. I'll just try to make all this pain and chaos useful. I mean, isn't that how you make art? Just take the longing and the fear and the heartache and the dread, and the ability to see these broken pieces of yourself are like cracks in an armor through which you're able to see the world. You're too broken to be normal, kid. But you're just broken enough to see beauty. And since you can't do anything else, you can't hold a job or maintain a relationship with another human being, just lock yourself in a room and get on with it. Right. So I decided to start a band. I'd started a writing career, which is doing pretty well, but I decided to abandon it all and just start a rock band. And it felt like a crazy decision, like this huge life change. But so I did what I always did. I talked to my dad about it. And we went to Hollywood Park, and we returned there again, and we sat up in the stands like we always did, and we ate our food and discussed the races. And at some quiet moment, I told him I was scared I was going to fail, scared people would laugh at me. And I always remember he said, let them laugh. That's how every great story begins, when you don't know how it's going to work out. That's what makes it a great story. Well, so to my surprise, it worked out. The band went on the road and people showed up and they knew the words to all these sad songs I was writing. And it felt like my dreams were coming true. You know, there's this idea that rock and roll is going to save you. This romantic, peripatetic sense that, oh, I can just live out here on the road. I don't need people. I don't need anyone. I don't need closeness or a real relationship, which of course I'm bad at. Can't even do it. I can only sing about it. So it was like a choice to do something else instead. It was safe because I had my whole life performing. And here we are at the show and I can do this. I can always perform. That's what I'm good at. That's the fucking problem. And so you look up and there's all these people and it feels like a dream. Like I'm walking into the ocean to disappear. Here are all these people and they're walking out into the waves with me. And they're all here. And it's this place you tried to bring the whole world into, like the child you once were who built this castle in the sky, except now you've become the ghost that haunts that castle in the sky because that's where you live, right in the performance. And meanwhile, the thing I didn't admit was how lonely I was, how lost I felt. And rock and roll wasn't going to save me. It's an evening, and then it's over. It's a song, and then it's over. It has nothing to do with feeling whole or loved or seen. But I kept trying, and I kept going into these same patterns. At the start, I meet someone. I'm feeling good, and then, no, wait, I'm scared. I can't do it. I got to leave. At the start, I'm feeling good, and then, no, wait, I can't do it. I got to leave. Now I'm going to write a song about it. And here I wrote this sad song, and people love the song, and isn't that great? And here I am at the center of it all thinking, this is all I'm ever meant to be. So I had this moment in Amsterdam, and we'd been touring through Europe and drinking too much and hardly slept. And I'd eaten two pot brownies, which is always a bad idea, at some cafe on a canal, and then went back to my hotel room. And then the weed hit me like all at once. And I sat on the edge of my bed, and I had this vision of my life. I sat there with my arms around myself, just shaking, like back and forth for like 8 hours. And I had this vision of this guy who was just performing and performing his sadness, and he was just trying to sing about his love. But in his heart, what the fuck did he know about love? In his heart, there was nothing but shit, nothing but darkness and emptiness, because it had never occurred to him to put anything else there instead. Something sacred. And it was so clear to me that what was needed was to, what needed to be there was true love, real love, worthy of honor and fidelity. And you know, it's hard to feel like you can't change. To admit it to yourself and still you can't change. To whisper it in a willing ear at dawn and still you can't change. To tell it to a friend who says, yeah, call me, we can talk about it. And still you can't change. To write it a song about it. To dream it in metaphor, in irony, and still you can't change. To scream it into a microphone in front of thousands of people, your voice amplified at some ungodly volume, into this place you tried to bring the whole world into. And you still can't change. And you realize you're in that place alone. And so the day came when I walked into a quiet courtyard and there was this fountain and these beautiful trees. And I went to a therapist's office and I sat down and he said, so why are you here? And I said, what do you mean? He said, what makes you seek therapy? And I said, without even thinking about it, I want to be able to fall in love and I can't. And I know I'm the problem and I have to change. It's hard to describe therapy except that you realize it's important to know yourself. You have to get to know yourself, especially when you're someone who spent your whole life performing. You spent your whole life living behind a mask, behind this facade that you create for other people. So you don't know yourself at all. Because there was never a way to say the things you actually felt. Just like this orphan child who learned at an early age to dance instead, to look at the faces of the adults and say whatever was needed to get his needs met. And that orphan child just created this man. And that man just spent his life scared, putting on facade after facade after facade. And once I started to look at it, I found all sorts of things which surprised me. I had grief in places I didn't expect. I had joy in other places. So much sadness, so much shame. But I worked through it. And over time, I started to understand myself. And when I finally found love, after 5 years of therapy, I think I was ready. I think it's because I realized it is a breathless commitment. It's a powerful commitment you make when you fall deeply in love. You give someone so much power to hurt you and to uplift you, and they give you so much power. And so I realized the heart of love had to be an epic friendship. Like somewhere deep in your soul, edge of the earth, last day of the universe type conversation, you say to this person, I trust you. And you can trust me. So it felt a lot like adding new features to the landscape of my mind. These things that weren't there before. There was this big, wide open valley of forgiveness that I never had. There was this shady grove for tolerating the fear that once prompted me to run. There was a church of loyalty. Just to understand how sacred it is to be loyal, that it requires a sacrifice, because sometimes it's boring, and that's okay. Be bored. It'll pass. And then the church will remain intact, and you can sleep without secrets, and you can wake up knowing you finally honored that most sacred thing that you finally learned to place right at the center of your heart. The other day when we were walking by the graveyard near the house, you asked me if I thought we would ever die. And if life and love both fade so predictably, we've made ourselves a kind of predictable lie. And so I pictured us like corpses lying side by side in pieces in some dark and lonely plot under a bough. We look so silly there, all decomposed, half turned to dust in tattered clothes, that we probably look just as silly now. Bye, 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 bye to all this dogged innocence. I can't pretend that I can tell you what is going to happen next or how to be. But you have no idea about me, do you? So it left me to wonder if people ever know each other, to stumble around like strangers in the dark. Cause sometimes you seem so strange to me, I must seem strange to you. We're like two actors playing our parts. Did you memorize your lines? Cause I did. Here's the part where I get so mad, I tell you that I can't forgive you, pal. And you get so quiet now, and you seem somehow like a lost and lonely child, and you just hope that this moment won't last. Bye, 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 bye to all this dogged innocence. I can't pretend that I could tell you what is going to happen next or how to be. But you have no idea about me. You have no idea about me. Do you? Something tying our feet to the ground. A moment passed, we hear how it sounds. Then it seems a little less profound, like we're all going the same way down. Cause we're all going the same way down. I'm just trying to write it all down. I write songs and you write letters. We are tied like two in tethers, and we talk and read and laugh and sleep at night in bed together. And you wake in tears sometimes. I can see the thoughts flash across your eyes. They say, darling, will you be kind? Will you be a good man and stay behind if I get old? And then the letters all pass through my head with the words that I was told, about the fading flesh of life and love, the failures of the bold. I can list each crippling fear like I'm reading from a well. And I'll defy everyone and love you still. I will carry you with me up every hill. And if you die before I die, I'll carve your name out of the sky. And then I'll fall asleep with your memory, and I'll dream of where you lie. Some say it's better to move on and to let life just carry on, and I may be wrong. Still I'll try. 'Cause it's better to love whether you win or lose or die. It's better to love whether you win or lose or die. It's better to love whether you win or lose or die.